हेलो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू सरस्वती शिशु कुंज वघवाला बोरसद इंग्लिश मीडियम सब्जेक्ट मैथ्स स्टैंडर्ड 5th चैप्टर नंबर 3 हाउ मैनी स्क्वेयर्स। इन अर्लियर वीडियो वी हैव सीन अबाउट पेरीमीटर एंड एरिया ऑफ स्क्वेयर एंड रेक्टेंगल, सो लेट्स सी अगेन रिकैप व्हाट इज पेरीमीटर। We have learned definition also. So, what is the definition of perimeter? The total length around a closed figure is called perimeter. Once again, the total length around a closed figure. Suppose this is a figure. So, when we are finding perimeter, so we are measuring total length of a figure from A to B. C D means from here to here to here to here. This is called perimeter of a rectangle. Same way we can find perimeter of square also. Square also from here to here, here to here, here to here, and here to here. Now, what is the formula for finding perimeter of rectangle and square? So, perimeter of rectangle is equals to, suppose this is length, this is breadth, this is length, this is breadth. So we have learned formula 2 into L plus B. This is the formula of finding perimeter of rectangle that we have learned in last video. Now what is perimeter of square? Suppose this is side, side, side and side. So what is the perimeter of square? Perimeter of square is equals to 1, 2, 3, 4 times S. So, 4 into S. So, this is the perimeter of square. So, we have learned in earlier video about perimeter of rectangle and perimeter of square. Now, let's see about perimeter area of square and rectangle. What is area? What is the definition of area and what is the formula of area of rectangle and area of square? Let's see. Area. Area means the surface, the space occupied, the space occupied by an object, the space inside an object. Suppose this is a rectangle. So whatever space inside this space which is occupied by a shape is called its area. It's called its area. So the space occupied by a plane figure, the space occupied by a plane figure is called its area. Same way in square. So whatever space inside a square, that is its area. So the space occupied by a plane figure is called its area. Now let's see its formula. Area of rectangle is equals to, what is the formula of area of rectangle? Suppose this is length and this is breadth. So L into B. So formula is L into B. So the formula of area of rectangle is L into B. Now let's look on square. What is the formula of, what is the formula of area of square? Suppose this is side and this is side. So area of square means side into side, means side multiplied by side. So this is the formula of area of square. So I hope you have understood. Now we will continue our further chapter.
Now here we have one question. We have a sheet of paper and dots are drawn on the sheet of paper. Now we have to solve a question on equation. Let's read first question that we will understand. Measure the sides of the red square on the dotted sheet. Means here sheet is given and one square is given. This is in red color. We have to measure these red color sides. So let's measure the By using square, this is eighth month and this is sixth month and seventh month rectangle. Okay, so we have a seven different rectangle by using square on sheet of paper. Hope you understand in this question. Now we will go to next question.
In question number 1, we have solved sheet of paper, dotted sheet paper. In that, we have find out seven different rectangle. Which are the seven different rectangle which we have find in the sheet of dotted sheet? Let's see which are the seventh. Number 1, number 2, number 3, number 4, number 5, number 6 and number 7. These are the seven different rectangles which we have found or we have made. Now we have here question, two questions are there. The two questions we will solve by reading this paragraph. So let's start. Each rectangle is made up of 12 equal squares. So all have the same area, but the length of the boundaries will be different. As we have seen in that seven different rectangle, all the rectangles having same area. Why they have same area? Because they in that rectangle we use 12 squares only. So that's why their area is same in all seven rectangles. So now here two questions are there that we have to solve. So let's solve it. Question number 2 is that which of this rectangle has the longest perimeter? Once again, which of this rectangle has the longest perimeter? And third question is like that, which of these rectangles has the smallest perimeter? Means we have to find perimeter of rectangle and we have to find which of the rectangle having longest perimeter and which of the rectangle having shortest perimeter from that seven rectangles. So which are the seven rectangle? We will categorize into three parts, A, B and C. Why? Because A, if we talk about A rectangle, in that two rectangles whose length was 12 cm and breadth was 1 cm, two rectangles were there. So their length is equals to 12 cm and breadth is equals to 1 cm. How many rectangles are there of this size? Two rectangles. Number 1 and number 2 are the rectangles of 12 cm and breadth is equal to 1 cm. Two rectangles were there. Second rectangle, B number rectangle, rectangles whose length was 4 cm and breadth was 3 cm. Number of rectangles were 4 rectangles. C rectangles, that is how the length was 6 cm and breadth was 2 cm. Number of rectangle were only 1. So 2 plus 4 plus 1 is equals to 7 rectangles. So 2 rectangles whose length was 12 cm and breadth 1 cm. 4 rectangles were there whose length was 4 cm and breadth was 3 cm. And 1 rectangle whose length is 6 cm and breadth is 2 cm. So 7th one rectangle is this one. Then 3rd, 4th, 5th and 6th are the rectangle of having length 4 cm and breadth 3 cm. Hope you understand in this 3 A, B and C type rectangle. Now let's find out their perimeter by using formula of perimeter. Let us find their perimeter. Rectangle whose length is equals to 12 cm and breadth is equals to 1 cm. So now length and breadth of a rectangle is given. So let us find out their perimeter. So perimeter of rectangle, what is the formula of perimeter of rectangle? 2 into bracket L plus B, 2 multiply by into bracket L plus B. So this is the formula which we have to use and we have to find out the answer. So 2 will remain as it is. What is the value of L? 12 cm. So 12 cm and breadth 1 cm. So we write 1 cm. So 12 plus 1, how much? 13 centimeter. Now 13 into 2, 2 multiply by 13, how much? 13 2s are 26. So answer is 26 centimeter. So we get the perimeter of rectangle whose length is 12 centimeter and breadth is 1 centimeter is equals to 26 centimeter. Now next one is, this is rectangle type A. Rectangle A. Now we will find for B rectangle whose length is is equals to 4 cm and breadth is equals to 3 cm. So let us find out their perimeter. So perimeter of rectangle is equals to 2 into bracket L plus B. So let's place their value. 2 will remain as it is. L is equals to 4 cm. And B is equals to 3 cm. So 4 plus 3, 7. 7 cm multiply by 2. So 7 2s are how much? 7 2s are 14 cm. So we get the perimeter of B rectangle is 14 cm. What was the perimeter of A rectangle? That was 26 cm. Now last one, C rectangle. So perimeter of rectangle whose length is equals to 6 cm and breadth is equals to 2 cm. Now we have to find the perimeter of last C rectangle. Let's find out. So perimeter of rectangle is equals to 2 into L plus B is equals to 2 into what is L? 6 cm and B 2 cm. So 6 plus 2, 8 cm. So 8 into 2, how much? 8 2 ja 16. So answer is 16 cm. So we get the perimeter of C rectangle is 16 cm. So we get all the three rectangles perimeter. First one, 8A rectangle is equals to 26, B is equals to 14 and C rectangle is equals to 16 cm. Now we have to answer the two questions. Which of these rectangle has the longest perimeter? So you can observe in this question three sums, which rectangle have
largest perimeter. So you can see 26, 14 and 16. So which number is bigger? 26. So we can write rectangle, or you can say a rectangle is the longest, or a rectangle has the longest perimeter. Same way, next question is, which of these rectangle has the smallest perimeter? So you can observe again 26, 14 and 16. Which is the smallest number? 14. So B rectangle is the smallest, has the smallest perimeter. So we can write answer, B rectangle has the smallest perimeter. I hope you understand all the questions. Thank you.